Hello everyone and welcome to another RPG Maker tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make exploding chests. Now these are just normal chests that have a chance of exploding in the player's face. Not every chest will have this chance. I'd advise doing that because, you know, it's going to be a bit tedious if every one of your chests is exploding all the time. So let's go over the chest event. So what you want to do is create a quick event and just create a treasure chest. I've made mine gold because it's going to contain gold in it. Then everything in the contents will change. Everything else will remain the same like a normal chest. I've called it exploding chest. The first thing what you want to do in this contents at the very top is create a variable. So you do control variables. I've called it RNG, which stands for random number generator. And I've set it between 3 and 4. So you click random and then you can control the probability that this event is going to need, right? So you can have between 1 and 50. And that means there'll be a 1 in 50 chance, or even a 2 in 50 chance, whatever you want. But it'll be a very low chance of the explosion from happening. So you might want to have it more like 1 in 10. So that means every 1 in 10 of your chests is going to explode in the player's face. Like, that's the probability of it. But as this is a control, I've done between 3 and 4. Now the reason I've done between 3 and 4 is because there's going to be two chances or two different variations of the explosion. What I mean by that is when the player opens a chest, if they get the number that means it's going to explode, if the variable is equal to the number in the conditional branch, then the player is going to have to press a button. So I don't want it to be the same button every time, because then the player will know to always hold shift, because in this case you stop the chest from exploding by holding shift. And if it was the same on every chest, then every time the player opened a chest, they would just hold shift just in case. So we want to make it so that the player has to be on edge, basically, because there's going to be a little countdown timer, a little image that pops up showing what button the player needs to press to stop the explosion. So I've got the shift key and the escape key. I'll show you those pictures in a minute, but that's why I've got between 3 and 4, because there's going to be two variations of which button to press. So let's go into the conditional branch. You can do it with just one, but I would advise doing it with two if you can. So after you've done your control variables, RNG, then you create a conditional branch. Everything else in this page of the event works inside of this conditional branch. So the first thing is this variable, is RNG equal to 3? Have an else branch as well, it's quite important, because I think that starts off unticked, so make sure you've got that ticked. So if it is equal to 3, that means it's going to explode. So then we want to play the chest sound effect. We're going to have the normal movement route that's, it's in the default chest that's made. But then we're going to have a little sound effect that's going to be like, something's gone wrong, it's going to explode. So you're going to hear that, and it's going to be like, oh my god, it's going to explode. So then what you want to do, after you've got your little sound effect, is you want to show picture. This is to show the player what button they need to press to stop the explosion. In this case, I've made a image of a shift key. It's not got the little arrow on it, but it clearly says shift, so the player's going to know to press the shift key. The thing is, you have to hold the key down, otherwise timing it, just pressing it once, is going to be quite difficult to time. So in hindsight, I would say have the word hold shift rather than just shift. That way the player knows that they've got to hold the shift button down. But anyway, so I've made it. My game's resolution is 1280 by 720. So this image is that size, and the shift key is right in the middle of it. So when you do show picture, I've got upper left, and that'll mean like the shift key will appear right in the middle of the screen. I've numbered it 11 because I've got 10 other images before that that are working for the HUD of the game. So make sure you pay attention to what number your image is when you do show picture, because you're going to need to erase it. So as it's a countdown, we're going to do a wait frame command. So I've picked 12 frames. Then we're going to erase picture 11. You know, you can go to erase picture down here. So you've got show picture and erase picture. So we're going to show the picture, or wait 12 frames, erase the picture, wait 4 frames. It's quite important that you have something like this, otherwise the picture will just disappear and reappear too quickly. There's got to be something in between erase picture and show picture. So we've got the picture's appeared, it waits, it disappears, it waits. We play the buzzer sound effect again, and then we show the picture again. And this time we wait 10 frames, so it's slightly less time than the previous round. So basically, it's just copy and paste these 5 commands over and over, but every time, the first wait command, you reduce by 2 frames. So that's going to be like, the buzzer's going to sound quicker every time, and it's going to create a sense of urgency. That's why I've done that sort of quicker reduced time frame, you know, for every countdown. So when I've got down to just 4 frames, then we're going to do another conditional branch. So this time, if the shift button is pressed down, then it will play a chime sound effect to show the player they've done the right thing. They've held the shift button down. The chime says, congratulations, you've completed it. Then you get your gold. So change the gold or whatever item you've got in the chest. Have the text pop up. And then control self switch A, which will turn it into the normal chest that you would normally see. So some of this stuff is basically what's in a normal chest. It's just in different places. So then what to do if the player fails to press the shift button in time? So on this conditional branch, we've got another else. So remember, tick that create else branch. So on the else for the if the shift button is pressed down, then you want to have a buzzer to say, uh-oh, you did it wrong. Doo-doo. So then we'll wait 25 frames. We'll show an animation on the chest event. I've chosen fire 1-2, which is just an explosion, you know, sort of animation. Then we're going to do set movement route. So I want the player to be sort of thrown backwards away from the chest. So choose player as your movement route target. Then you want to have walking animation off, because they would end up moonwalking if you had that on. So if you have it off, then they won't look as if they're walking. It will just look like they've been thrown straight back. I've changed the speed and the frequency to highest because I want them to be thrown back like rather quickly. I've had one step backwards 3 times, so they move 3 squares away from the chest. Then we've got to remember, turn the walking animation back on and reset the frequency and speed of your character to their normal thing. Make sure you have skip if cannot move on, because if you get blown into a wall, then you don't want to lock the game up. So make sure you've got that. Wait for completion. And then self switch B is on. So you failed to press the shift key. The event, well, the chest has blown up in your face. The player has been thrown backwards. Self switch B is on. So create another page. Self switch B is on. I've done stepping animation because I've chosen this smokier graphic here. So there's a little bit of smoke where the chest used to be. And then I've done it as parallel, waits 200 frames, cell switch C is on, and then the smoke disappears. This page, cell switch C is the condition, and there'll be nothing on this page, it'll be blank. So that's how we get the chest to explode. But then we go back to, okay, so we've got the shift way, the shift key to stop the chest from exploding. But what if this random number turns out to be a 4? Then, so we go down, we go past this condition, all the way down to this else branch. So this else is at the end. If RNG is free, then this happens. If it's not, else, then we do another conditional branch in the else part. If RNG is equal to 4, then we'll just copy and paste everything we've just done. But this time, we're going to change the picture to the escape image. So this time, I've made the same image, but I've just made it escape key. Everything else is the same. I've numbered it 12. Then everything else is the same. Erase picture 12, though. So it's like flash the picture up, erase it, flash it up, erase it, flash it up, erase it, and so on and so forth. Then we have at the end of that another the same conditional branch as before, but in this time instead of having if the button shift is pressed down, we do if button cancel is pressed down. Now, by default, the cancel button in RPG Maker is the escape key, so that's why I've chosen the escape image that I use. And then basically, it's all the same. It's just, is this button pressed down? Then at the end of all of that, so then we have else. So this is if it's not number 3, and if it's not number 4, then the chest will open as normally. So in this case, we're not going to be able to get this outcome because I've chosen between 3 and 4 just to show off what happens. So when I change this between 1 and 10, then it's more likely it's going to skip past all of this and it will go straight to the very bottom, because it won't be 3 and it won't be 4. And then this is just the normal stuff that you would find in the chest, when you create a default chest. So play the chest sound effect, chest will open, cell switch A is on, change the gold, bit of text, you've got the gold, cell switch A is on, hurrah, brilliant. So it's all great. So that's all there is to it. So I'm going to quickly show you how that works, and then I will show you. In fact, hang on, let's do a quick copy and paste. So these five are all the same. So let's just move that one out of the way. I was experimenting with that one, but if we do another one here, but this one we will change the chance between 1 and say 1 in 20. That way we're pretty much guaranteed it's not going to be 3 or 4. It's going to be a much higher chance anyway. So then hopefully this one will be more like a normal chest, and these ones will all explode because they've all got between 3 and 4. So I'm quickly save it. So let's just walk through the wall like a boss. So we're going to open this chest, and it's either going to tell us to hold shift or hold escape. So there, I was holding the escape key down, and I managed to survive. Hold the shift key. Oh, I wasn't holding the shift key. I think I was holding the forward slash key by accident. So there you go. That's a perfect example of holding the wrong key down. Let's try this one. I held shift that time, and it opened fine. Hold escape. This time, I won't hold anything. Boom! It explodes. You see a little bit of smoke there? It's just going to disappear on its own. And this one, there you go. It's much more likely it's just going to open as normal. But there was still a 2 in 20 chance that it might explode in your face. So I hope you found this tutorial useful. It's just a little idea that I came up with. It's a bit silly, but you might want to use it in your game for a bit of random chance. This is also a cool way to do random loot as well. It doesn't have to be exploding chests. You can do, you know, if RNG is equal to 3, then you get a different piece of loot in your chest. I might make a different tutorial for that, but yeah. So if you found this helpful, give it a like. If you got any questions, if it's not working for you, put something in the comments and I'll see if I can help you out. If you've got any suggestions on what you'd like to see me do a tutorial on in the future, please let me know. I'd appreciate if you shared and subscribed, because it really encourages me to continue making tutorials. So hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, and I will see you on the next one. Bye.